Music Air Jazz.
Now boarding train 247, destination Jazz Central.
Hello and welcome to Jazz Central. I'm Angela Stribling. And tonight we've got something really special for you and also really funky. Mo Jazz recording artist Norman Brown is here. And he's going to start off the show with a song that was inspired by one of his musical influences, Wes Montgomery. Here is Take Me There on Jazz Central.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Jazz Central. I'm Angela Stribling. Norman Brown takes us back to a song from his first CD, Just Between Us. This is Love's Holiday on Jazz Central.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Jazz Central. I'm Angela Stribling with Mo Jazz recording artist, guitarist Norman Brown with Any Love and Lydian on Jazz Central.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Jazz Central. I'm Angela Stribling with guitarist Norman Brown. And here he is with That's the Way Love Goes on Jazz Central.
Thank you. Keyboards. Mr. Charles Love on keyboards. Mr. James Manning on the bass. Alonzo Scudicaro on the drums. My name is Norman Brown.
Welcome back to Jazz Central. I'm Angela Stribling with Norman Brown. How you doing?
Wonderful. Thank you, Angela. How you doing?
It's great to have you back here on our stages at
Thank
Jazz
you.
Central.
Thank you very much.
Music sounds really, really good.
Well, thanks a lot. We're having a ball. Thanks for having us back.
You know, for people who don't know a lot about your background, let's just talk about it a little bit and how when you were just a little Norman and used to sneak and play your brother's guitar.
Yeah, I'm still a little Norman. Yeah, my brother played guitar and he'd leave and I was so fascinated with it, I'd sneak and go play it. He busted me one day. And he said, you don't have to sneak and play it, man. You can play it whenever you want to. Ever since then, it's been a part of my life.
And even your dad kind of kicked in there
and made sure
that you played.
Well, I had wonderful family support. My father would just like to be serenaded. He'd sit in the basement, listen to me play all night. West Montgomery Records, George Benson Records. That was his way of, he would say, if you want to go, you want the car tonight, learn how to play this album.
Okay.
You know, that kind of thing. And it motivated me.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah,
I mean,
it was
especially
very cool.
Parents could take that hint in terms of motivating their children and just taking the time.
Well, I never got that. When are you going to get a real job? When are you going to, you know, we never went down that road at all.
Mm-hmm.
So very much family support.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's even nice in reading the liner notes of your last album, how you really thanked your dad for being your hero.
Oh, yeah. Pops.
That's what
I call him. He's a kid.
So you mentioned George Benson and Wes Montgomery and certainly their influences, but also one that I kind of took notice of, Jimi Hendrix,
yes, the Band of Gypsies. First time I heard Jimmy play, it blew my mind, man. He had the guitar talking and screaming, and it was a whole different bag than what Wes was doing. And I fell in love with that. I got the headband, big afro, you know, trying to cop that style.
Oh, I'm trying to imagine that.
So now I'm actually trying to bring that back, that flavor of my playing.
Mm-hmm.
And you really hear it more so when you hear me play live. It's more energy, more energetic, and I'm bending the strings. You know, it's just playing more energetic than I do on record.
You put so much emotion in when you're performing live.
Thank you. I love
and
it.
You're singing a lot. Your voice is beautiful. I'm glad to hear you using it.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. I've been kind of fighting with the record company about that.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, well, I sang one on the After the Storm album, which I thought should have been a single.
Mm-hmm.
We should have done a nice video on it and the whole nine. Because when I perform it live, people love it. But instrumentalist singing, people still aren't used to that concept yet. They think we're selling out, not jazzers. But the bottom line to me is the music is in my heart. The voice is another tool. So
yeah.
Once I learn to use that, I just have another axe to communicate on.
Exactly.
That's how I look at it.
Similar to the history of George Benson.
Yes,
people heard
definitely.
Him play the guitar. And
George
then he
started
had to
it.
Gradually work in that I've got a voice too.
But you know, Angela, a bit of history. The very first jazz musician to improvise was Louis Armstrong. he set the standard for jazz. He was the first musician to play an improvised solo without it being written out on paper, to play off the top of his head. Louis Armstrong sang. He sang popular songs all the time. He set the standard from the very beginning. So all I'm doing is taking the torch and taking it on further so I can pass it on.
And why not? Because it all really does work.
Exactly.
And I understand with your new project that you're working on now, we are going to hear more of you singing.
Yes, yes, you will.
And what else? Tell me a little bit about the project.
Well, Better Days Ahead is the concept, and it's about positivity, positive inspiration. That's what I like to convey with my music. So I'm going to sing about four cuts on this album.
Nice.
Yeah, give more of the scat and more of that all-around flavor. Okay. But my guitar fans, I will be playing a lot.
Now, After the Storm, how is that still doing in record stores?
After the Storm is doing wonderful. It's almost gold. And it's been out.
Ooh, cross our fingers.
Yes. It came out in April of 94. I've been on the Billboard charts all that time. I think I've stayed above 15 position or something like that.
Excellent.
It's doing great, Angela.
Not to mention the Soul Train Music Award. Congratulations.
Yes. Ah! Yes.
So you've been rolling.
I have. I've been working very hard. I've been blessed. So I'm just trying to keep up now. My life is saying, come on, Norman, let's go. We got work to do.
So, you know, this has been an incredible year. You're on MoJazz, and things are going really well for you. And you've been touring, which is why this album that you've been working on isn't completed yet, right?
Exactly. After the Storm was so successful, there were so many live performance dates. People want me to play everywhere, and I love to play. So I'm going to go to the stage, wherever it calls from.
Yeah. And I understand you've been playing with some key people, Patti LaBelle.
Exactly. I got to open for Patti for about 3 months on a tour. Ooh. Grover Washington Jr., Al Jarreau. It's been wonderful.
Michael Franks,
yeah.
And you know, the Riffingtons.
Yeah.
But the list, they're all so totally different. And I'd imagine that they bring out different things in your music. Or are you always, you know, just Norman Brown is Norman Brown? Or do you change it up?
Pretty much I'm Norman Brown, but it's a variation each time. It's like the I Ching theory. Circumstances has everything to do with it. So each situation is totally unique just because of the different setting.
Is there ever an artist that you've had to tour with that was a little difficult, or just something really unique to that that might be different than like a Patti LaBelle versus a Michael Franks? When you're on tour with Patti, you expect X and Michael.
Right.
Why?
In this genre of music, everybody's cool. No egos floating around. They give me much respect.
Yeah.
So all I can do is return that.
Yeah.
So no, there haven't been any. I can't think of anyone.
That's great.
Yeah, I can't.
That's
wonderful.
It's
been very cool.
And what's nice is that you keep doing what you do so well, and I'm happy to know that you're back in the studio. When are we going to hear your new CD?
It'll be out.
Asking you all these personal questions.
I know. MoJazz, it's okay. The first single should be out in January. And then we'll look for a February album drop.
Yeah. Now, are you thinking that they're going to release Norman Brown on vocals first or the guitar?
I'm going to have to give them a little bit of both for that first single. I'm going to have to come out with what my fans expect and want to hear, which is some screaming guitar playing.
Yeah.
That's the bass I've built, as well as some new flavors, something interesting, something else, an extension. Yeah, so I'm going to have to combine all of that in that first single, I believe.
I love it.
Yeah.
Well, very good, Norman.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Angela.
It's always wonderful to see you.
All right.
And
thanks a lot.
We all want to hear your music, so I'm going to let you get back up there.
All right, great.
So we'll be back with Norman Brown on Jazz Central. Stay with us. Welcome back to Jazz Central as we come to the close of this hour with Norman Brown. He's going to leave us with a song called Family, but first, here is After the Storm on Jazz Central.